Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's look at using markers in iMovie. So I'm using iMovie version 10 and we're going to look at using a feature called markers. So markers allow you to just place marks along some video. So for instance, let's drag some video into an empty project here. And at any point here I can add a marker. I can go to Mark, Add Marker, but you can see it's really what you're supposed to do is use M here to add a marker. So I can go right here and add a marker, M, another marker there, anywhere I want. And the use of these markers is simply as a place to snap to. So you can see how the timeline kind of snaps to it. So if I want to add another video, say a cutaway here, I could bring it in and you can see it's going to snap to this marker. It's kind of useful because you can snap multiple things to the same marker or kind of predefine where you want things to be. Like for instance, let's add a title here and you'll see I'll be able to snap that to the marker as well. So I just drag and drop the standard title and you can see how it snaps to it right there. Same thing for audio, same thing for anything, photo, anything you want to add, you can easily use markers to have it snap to it. And you can drag these markers around. They don't have names or anything. You can remove them. Also the keyboard shortcut, Control Shift M removes them there pretty easily. And one of the cool things about them is that you can add them while the video is playing. So I'm going to hit the spacebar to play here. And as the video is playing, I can hit M at any time and it adds a marker. So I can watch my video and when I see there's something I want to add, a title or something at some point, I can simply hit an M there to mark the spot. So you can kind of use this like beat markers. You can, let's start with a black background here from Maps and Backgrounds. And then let's make this long enough so it covers the song. It's about a 30 second song. So we'll do 30 seconds. And then we're going to add music. We can add that as the background to this. And we can add it as the background or we can attach it to that. It doesn't really matter. As long as it's going to play and we have this track here, this black background track, to add markers to. So now I could go back here and I could play and then hit M wherever I think the photo should change during a slideshow. So next I'm going to add the photos. I'll go to my iPhoto library and I have some photos here I can use as samples. I'll add them as basically cutaways above this black background. And as soon as I add them I can shrink them and you can see how it's going to snap to the marker, which is really nice and makes it easy. Not quite as easy as beat markers, which would have just been able to lay in a bunch of them at a time. I can lay in a bunch of photos at a time, but they're all going to be the same duration, which may actually work for matching to a beat, but this gives you more versatility and it's relatively quick. So now when I play this back, we'll see that the photos change to the beat. And markers are so much more useful than just for music. You can add them anywhere you want for any reason. So for instance, like if I wanted to add some sound effects to this, I can add some sound effects at the right points just by skimming through the video and adding some explosion sound effects at the right spot. Or even some flashes on the screen or some other special effect or putting titling in certain places, captions, if I'm going to use titling for captions, that kind of thing. So anything you want where you have to kind of, you want to snap items to a spot on the iMovie timeline, it's useful to use markers.